Let's start by setting the project path. Import the body model and make sure it's exactly in the origin. Create a box and check the height of the creature. He's very tall, I want him to be about 220 cm. Reduce the size by 80%. Use this rounded number because you need to do the same to the prop model as well. The most important step after resizing the model is to apply a ResetX form to it, because we have changed the uniform scale, which can cause some issues, especially in the rigging process. We can find the uniform scale value by checking the transform in the view coordinate system, or using this simple command $.scale. Select the model, go to the utilities and press the ResetX form button, and convert the model to a detailed body. Create three layers, geometry, controllers, and bones. I assume that you know about gimbal lock. If you don't, check the link below for an in-depth explanation. Try to create bones in a way that the primary rotation of them is on their z-axis, which means for the leg bones we should use side views like left or right, and top view for arms. Enable the bone layer and start creating the leg bones. We can edit them later. Create a small bone for the kneecap as well. Select the root bone and move it in x-axis. Enable local mode in rotation and rotate the bone until it matches the knee and toes. Rename the bones to thigh, knee, kneecap, ankle, and toe. We can edit the bones using bone tools by enabling the bone edit mode. Before moving the bones, make sure you are in the local coordinate system and do not move them in the z-axis. Also, you have to have a small angle between the thigh and the knee, so the IK solver knows where to bend. Select all the bones and press Reset Stretch. To create the right leg, use the mirror button in the Bone Tools dialog. Turn off the bone edit mode, select the root bone and in the view coordinate system invert the value of its x-axis. But we have a problem now. Select both thigh bones and rotate them in the local coordinate system and pivot point center mode. We have correct rotation behavior only in y-axis, but I want to have it in x-axis and z-axis as well. I'm doing this because I want to have a rig that can be mirrored. So it's worth doing the following. Select all the mirrored bones and go to the hierarchy tab. Enable affect pivot only and rotate the y-axis by 180 degrees. Now if I press reset stretch, this happens. We need to revert their width and height. And for the knob bones, it's safer to recreate them using the Create End button. You can see we have this mirrored suffix applied to them. So use the Rename Objects tool to remove the last 10 characters from their names, but also add an R as the prefix. Repeat the same for the left legs without the remove last checkbox enabled. And add L as the prefix. Go to the right view and create three bones for the spine, one for the neck and one for the head. Create another bone for the pelvis and align it to the spine only in position. Select the thigh bones and spine one and link them to the pelvis bone. Although they are in the center and they don't need R or L for prefix, but I like to follow my naming structure, so add C for center or M for middle to all of them. And that's it for this video. See you in the next one.